Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are actually back to my channel, and if you're new to my channel, you're also welcome. This is the first course that I'm creating for research paper. I have so many other ideas that I will create videos about productivity, things that I like in the tech, the apps that I use, the software, basically everything about productivity and my life experience. I'm going to explain it in this channel. But I started with this research paper writing because everyone is asking me about it. So let's jump into the slide. All right, so this is the third video I'm creating about understanding the research paper and how to write a research paper. And as you can see, this is the third one. I'm going to create 31 videos for you guys. All right. So in this slide, I'm going to show you the structure of a research paper. As you can see here, we have four main sections for a research paper. The first one on the top is the introduction, and then method, and then results and discussion, and then conclusion. There are some other like sections you might have seen, but this is basically the main structure of every single scientific research paper. All right, now let me explain this in a little bit more detail. For the method, you might have seen different names for these. In some journals, they might call it materials and methods. In some other journals, might call it experimental procedures or theory. So it really depends on the theme or however they like to call it. So how does it work? So in general, when you start to write a research paper, you have to start from a more broad and general thing. Let's say if you are working on a medicine that cures cancer, let's say breast cancer, you can't say, all right, the first sentence of your paper, you are not going to say what the breast cancer is. No, you have to show the big picture, show some numbers, say this many people suffer from the cancer, and then start to, you know, go and become more specific into your niche, whatever you have done. All right, so you have to start from a more broad general topic and then dive in and tune it to the more specific thing that is related to your research, right? So it's like a cone shape. And then you have your field. This is your field. The method and the results and discussion is what you can talk about. No one knows what you are doing. This is your field, and whatever you have done in the lab, the research, the data you have, this is basically the center of your research paper. And then you have to dial back, you know, you have to say, all right, this is the results we got, and now how do I can use these results to solve the problem, or what's the future of it? How does it relate to the broad picture, right? So then you go to a more general again. So this is like the shape that it has, right? So I put a sand timer here. So it's like a sand timer. So every single scientific research paper does have this shape. If it doesn't, then it lacks the, you know, the clarity. So it goes straight to the research, or it's like, you know, it talks about everywhere. So it has to have this type of a structure, right? Now, let's talk about the other sections that are also included into any research paper. So I'm going to start from the top. So every paper has a title for sure. And after that, it comes the author and affiliation. Then graphical abstracts. So as you can see, I put like two asterisks over there. I mean, here, this is optional. Not all the journals require you to have a graphical abstracts, but there are many of them out there that they want you to submit a graphical abstract. And then it comes the keywords, and then the abstract, and then the acknowledgments, the author contribution, references, and then supplementary information. This supplementary information, usually people call it SI, but there are other names for it. They might call it supplementary data, supporting materials, or supporting info. And as I said, the ones that comes with two asterisks, they are like optional. All right, so now just a slight slightly different version of this structure I have shown in on the left, you can see it on the right, which means like in some journals they want you to put the method into the supplementary information. Why? Because there are some, you know, limited number of pages that you can have in your paper. They even might have like a requirement if you submit your paper that might be less than a certain number of words or certain number of like pages. So it's like they say, all right, let's put the method into the supplementary information, because the supplementary information, let me call it SI. It's hard to say it back to back. So the SI, they put it online. So it's not when you download a paper, it comes with it. No, you have to go back to the website and download the SI if you want to. And usually it's like the most boring part of the paper is out there. Like it tells you what method they have used, what theory they are using, what's the formula, how to make this or that. So it's not something that you immediately need to have access to. You know, the introduction, result and discussion, and conclusion, they are important. You have to know it, you know, once you start to read the paper. But it comes next. If you are interested, then you can go back and check it. All right. Here I have shown like a snapshot of what each part, you know, the most important parts of these structure have to answer. There are many questions that I have listed here. I am not going to go through all of these right now. Why? Because I'm going to create one video for every single section you are seeing here. Every single of these is going to have its own video. So you can take a screenshot, read it on your own, but I will go through them later in the next videos. All right, let me show you some examples now. All right, the first example, this is my paper, 5 pages. And let me show you the different parts of this paper so that you see the title, the author, abstract, and then it comes the introduction, then affiliation, and then continues of the introduction, results and discussion, and then results and discussion, and then conclusion, and then the references. So it's all the parts that I talked about, right? Sometimes there is no clear like boundary between the sections. Let me go back to the first one, for instance, here. The first page, it doesn't clearly says abstract, you know, this is abstract. Or, you know, sometimes they don't have like a clear subtitle saying, oh, this is the result and discussion. No, they might just start explaining. And it's like a like just going from one paragraph to next one. So just keep that in mind. And this is an SI of one of my papers. Let me just open that. That's what I'm talking about. SIs usually are like hundreds of pages, and they are like just data. How, like, it depends on your field of study. For me, as a like a chemistry major, this is it does have its own table of contents, actually. So it says like how we create these materials, like and then the spectra data, the computational methods, and all of that, the NMRs. So all of these, if I want to put this into the actual paper, you know, it's going to be a lot of pages. So sometimes even like if you have many figures in your paper, they might ask you to move them to the SI. So yeah, now let's go back to the second example. All right, so here I'm showing another example. Again, here, title, authors, affiliations, abstract, introduction. Here, you can see it doesn't say introduction, dot, dot, and then start. No, there's no clear indication that that's introduction, but that's how usually a paper does start. And then results and discussion, and then conclusion again. You see here, there is no wording saying this is conclusion. No, the last paragraph is the conclusion. And then here, the method goes to the SI. And then the references. So this is the second example. Now the third example. Here, I want to show you this example because some of the papers might have some subsections for the results and discussion or other parts of the paper. So results and discussion here, as you can see, there are six sections, and the second section has its own subcategory, and like the headers are like it starts from here, let's say it says 3-2 and then 3-2-1 and so on and so forth. Okay, all right, so the title, the author's abstract, introduction, affiliation, method, and then we go to the results and discussion, continues of the results and discussion, and then conclusion, and then references. Yeah, so this is like three examples I've shown you here, but now I'm going to show you one more example. This is one simple example that really helped me to come up with this course, because I'm going to go back and refer to this example in the future videos, right? So this is the example that I came up with. Just imagine we you know, randomly created or did some genetic, you know, manipulation and came up with this kind of apple, which is half red, half green. Let's call it bicolored apple. We can call it like that. We can call it like half green, half red apple, whatever. So this is just one imaginary example that I'm going to refer to when I'm going through these sections. So from the title all the way to the conclusion and the other parts. So I'm going to refer back to this example. All right, this is the end of the third video. In the next video, I'm going to talk about the type of research papers. Yeah, that's it. See you in the next one.